Okay, we've been talking about this all morning long. The heads of Ontario's public and private sector unions say they are turning up the heat this summer on the Premier and his fellow PC caucus members. And this comes on news that the Ford government says it wants to cap wage increases to 1% for the next 3 years. What does that really mean? Jerry Diaz, the head of Canada's private union of Unifor, joins us now to talk about this. You're not happy this morning.
No, it's absolutely ridiculous. I mean, he's affecting workers in hospitals. Think about personal care workers who make very low wages today are going to be capped at 1%. That means wage increases of 15, 16 cents a year. So the question is, isn't it even constitutional that he can do this? So,
Jerry, you told me this doesn't surprise you.
No, listen, this is a far-right conservative agenda. Doug Ford makes Mike Harris look like a socialist, for crying out loud. So we're dealing with an economic strategy that's all about beer and fear. So people are going to react. People across the province are furious. Who cuts funding for kids with autism, cuts 3,000 teachers, $1 billion out of health care, and somehow says he's doing this for the betterment of working class? Give me a break.
We're talking about those wage caps. So this is our nurses, people in the school boards, colleges, universities, yep. Children's aid societies. The list goes on and on and on. But what can you do? We've seen a lot of protests, but not necessarily a reversal. We've seen a step back with the autism funding. They said, okay, well, now we're going to go look and do consultations. But what does that really mean? You're kind of shaking your head like, that doesn't mean much to me.
No, look, and this is a start. There's no question in my mind, because all it's been is cut, 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 cut. And they're attacking, in my argument, my opinion, the most vulnerable society. The first thing they did was they canceled the minimum wage increase to $15. So we are looking at an incredible austerity program. It's an austerity agenda. They cut $3.8 billion in corporate taxes. So they're taking the money from working class people, giving it to the corporation. So we've seen this dance before. I see us heading back to the days of action like we had during the Harris days.
Well, let's talk about you do have some days of actions happening June 7th and 8th, and they're going on summer break legislature. So what can be done to get the message out there?
Well, I think about the 30,000 people at Queen's Park that were protesting the education cuts. You're going to see a lot more of that. Canadians today, Ontarians have woken up to this agenda and says, hey, hold on here. This isn't what we voted for. Mm-hmm. Doug Ford didn't run in the last election and say, I'm going to cut here, do this. He didn't do any of that. He talked about being a working class hero, and he's a working class disaster.
Well, story far from over. Jerry Diaz, national president of Unifor. Appreciate your time. Thank you.
Thank you.
Let's get upstairs to Steph.